When we're talking about transceiver cables, so in other words, AOC, DAC, and AEC, we have the point-to-point connection, but we also have the breakout cable. Now, how does it actually work going from one transceiver to multiple transceivers? If you want to find out, stick around and we'll check it out. To understand how the breakout cables actually work, let's first have a look at how transceivers actually handle the higher data rates. Now, if we take the SFP transceiver, so the 1 gig SFP transceiver, technically speaking, it has one electrical lane, and that electrical lane has a bandwidth of 1 gig. When 10 gig transceivers were developed, the same physical form factor actually was used, but the bandwidth of that one electrical lane was broadened to 10 gig, and the resulting form factor then was called SFP+. However, the requirement for higher data rates in transceivers actually grew much faster than the technical ability to broaden the bandwidth of the electrical lane. And that's why a little trick was used. Let me explain. So let's talk about 100 gig as an example. Back in the days when 100 gig transceivers actually were developed, it technically wasn't really possible to have a higher data rate than 25 gig per electrical lane. And that's why, as you can see here, the trick was to just increase the number of electrical lanes, so in other words, then increase to 4. And that's also where then the name came from, so in other words, a QSFP, as in quad SFP, quad 4 times electrical lanes. And the same thing then also happened when we started talking about the 400 and 800 gig transceivers, because once again, although it was possible to have a higher bandwidth per electrical lane, that still didn't suffice for 400 and 800 gig. And that's why, once again, a new form factor was developed, or new form factors. So in other words, we then have the QSFP-DD, as in double density, doubling the quad, meaning 8, and the OSFP as an octo, Latin for 8. So in other words, as you can see here, we then have 8 individual electrical lanes. Now, these individual electrical lanes, they can also be used at different data rates. So you can have them at 10 gig, 25 gig, even 50 gig. And but that actually, these electrical lanes is the foundation for the for how breakout cables actually work. So let's take this AOC cable, for example. On this side, we have got a QSFP28 transceiver, so technically speaking, 4 electrical lanes at each 25 gig, and that then breaks out into 4 times SFP28, so in other words, 4 times 25 gig transceivers. Now, it isn't necessary for the breakout cables that they always break out into the same number of electrical lanes, because if we take, for example, a QSFP-DD 200 gig transceiver, which technically speaking is 8 times 25 gig, of course you can also have a breakout cable with 8 times SFP-28 transceivers, but you can also have a breakout cable going from the QSFP-DD 200 gig to 2 times QSFP-28 100 gig. And that basically is how the breakout cables work, and that's the same for AOC, DAC, and also the AEC cables. So, I hope you learned something today and that you enjoyed this video. If so, please leave a comment. And of course, remember to follow our channel because you want to have your regular dose of brain snacks. Until next time, bye-bye.